Today, in the United Nations Security Council, the U.S. condemned Russia and the Syrian government for an ongoing onslaught in Idlib province, the last holdout of Syrians opposed to the regime, where Russia, Syrian, and allied forces have driven hundreds of thousands from their homes. The offensive comes as two films about the Syrian war are nominated for Best Documentary in Sunday's Academy Awards. One of them is For Sama. And we should warn viewers now, there are graphic images that are difficult to watch. As part of our ongoing arts and culture series, Canvas, Nick Schifrin reports that For Sama is about the depth of the war's destruction and the triumph of love.
The darkest days of the Syrian war spared no one. Not the children who lost their lives as they played. Not the boys who lost a brother. And not the camera woman behind the lens documenting horror and confronting her own mortality.
I filmed just because I know that I will be next, killed or dead or injured, and I want to do my responsibility for these people.
Wa'ad el-Kateb was the camera woman, Hamza el-Kateb, the doctor who became her husband.
My first baby, Sama. Her name is meaning the sky. Sky we love, sky we want. Without air forces, without bombing.
And Sama, their daughter, for whom the film was made. In this war zone, they create a family. But Dad is one of the last remaining doctors in Aleppo. And this new life is surrounded by death. Surrounded by scenes of the unimaginable. Wa'ad films as a mother realizes her son is dead and carries his body through the street.
For everyone who was living in a war zone, you always had this scenario like, what I will do if my child was killed? What would I do if my wife was killed? What she will do if I was killed? In my head, it's always like being like, I lived this scenario that Sama is killed, Wa'ad is killed so many times.
It didn't start out so fatalistically. Wa'ad filmed the hope of the beginning of the Syrian revolution in 2011. The pride these Syrians felt in taking on Syrian President Bashar al-Assad. And the innocence of a doctor who became an anti-regime activist and the camerawoman who helped him.
That 2 years of the peaceful demonstration, it gave us like a lot of hope. It wasn't just like to change our life, but also something like you want to change the whole world.
And then Wa'ad gets pregnant. She says Sama represented hope even before she was born.
So many times when I was getting out to film some people or some stories outside when the destruction happened or any shelling happened, and I can feel Sama, you know, like that feeling of the life that I have inside my body, which, you know, like stood against every feeling, every bad feeling we've seen around.
But the Russian Air Force and Syrian bombardment on Aleppo were relentless. Their hospital is purposely bombed, killing 53 of their co-workers and friends. Wa'ad says at one point in Aleppo, there was no time to grieve. And surrounded by war, the children are not all right. Wa'ad films as children play in a bombed-out bus.
When I asked her about the bus she was painting, like, what happened to this bus? She said cluster bomb, and she's 4 years old, you know, and it was cluster bomb. So just like so complicated how they understand what's happening, how they adapt to that situation.
For Sama.
They want the film to become a wake-up call. Last weekend, they won Best Documentary at Britain's equivalent of the Oscars.
Thank you so much.
We're living for the day that accountability will happen. Like, we're fighting for this to happen. We keep, like, shedding the light about what's going on. Like, the film itself is like a document that shows all the war crimes that was committed. And, like, Wa'ad also has more footage. And all the citizen journalists that filmed all the war crimes that were committed in Aleppo and all over Syria in the past, like, 8 to 9 years.
Today, the darkest days of this war continue in Idlib, where the Syrians and Russians are trying to capture the last rebel stronghold.
There's now over than 3.5 million civilians who living inside Idlib, and the regime is still like shelling and bombing them with the help of Russia.
Edward Watts is Forsama's co-director.
We're trying to say to people in all these places we're going and in the sort of glitzy parties and award ceremonies, what you see in the film is still happening today, and in some ways worse than ever.
When they were still inside Syria, they didn't know whether they would survive. Waad filmed as the regime got to within one block of the hospital, and Hamza considered the unimaginable.
They killed daughters in front of their moms. They killed, like, fathers in front of their wives. And they were just, like, trying to rape people, torture them in very bad ways. When Hamza told me, like, let's just leave Sama in one room and close the door, because they don't want them to know that she is our daughter.
In a war defined by loss, what kept them alive was love. Waad filmed this scene right before Hamza proposed.
You don't know when any one of us could be killed. So what are we waiting for? Let's just, like, do that and share that love and share that responsibility with each other and go to this journey to the end. I love him, and he's, like, just a great, not just a doctor, but he's, for me, like, my hero.
Glad to hear that.
They are still in love today, as they were on their wedding day.
My wedding, when we were, like, dancing, we didn't care about what's happening, like, around. Yeah, we heard, like, kind of sound of the shelling, but the music that we were doing, it was, like, much, much louder.
And that's their final message. Even when things look impossibly bleak and a woman arrives dead, 9 months pregnant, and a baby seems lost, love and hope can overcome despair.
You know, I've seen that amazing feeling when, like, this baby is born. This is more stronger than all the shelling, all the bombing, all the crimes that the regime was doing.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.
What a powerful story. Forsama was broadcast on PBS's Frontline and is streaming for free on pbs.org/frontline and the PBS video app.